In 2018, Kilauea Volcano experienced its largest caldera collapse in more than 200 years, profoundly changing the landscape. Hawaii Volcanoes National Park, home of this popular visitor destination, was closed for 4.5 months due to unprecedented volcanic and seismic activity that damaged its infrastructure. Over a period of just a few months, the bottom dropped up to 500 meters with a total collapse area of 5 square kilometers. The collapse was accompanied by an outpouring of lava 40 kilometers from the summit that covered over 35 square kilometers of land, destroyed 700 homes, and displaced over 2,000 people. Scientists can often forecast when and where an eruption will occur. In 2018, there was clear warning of potential for eruption in the Lower East Rift Zone. Caldera collapses are fortunately rare, as they are associated with the largest volcanic eruptions. Sensitive monitoring equipment has helped scientists understand how magma moves below the surface, how it is stored, and what triggers a caldera collapse. So, what have we learned from this episode, and how might it improve our understanding of volcano hazards? Kilauea Volcano is the youngest and most active of the 5 volcanoes on the island of Hawaii. Eruptions are concentrated at the summit caldera and within 2 rift zones that radiate away from the summit. A cross-section will help us describe what happened in 2018, both at the summit caldera and within the East Rift Zone. The summits of most large shield volcanoes are occupied by collapse features called calderas. Calderas are large, basin-shaped volcanic depressions that form when magma is withdrawn or erupted from a shallow underground magma reservoir. Calderas are observed at hundreds of volcanoes around the world. Fortunately for us, caldera-forming eruptions are rare, as they can be extremely hazardous. Hawaiian caldera collapses tend to occur during passive eruption of fluid magma at distant vents, versus the more dangerous explosive volcanoes that form calderas during catastrophic eruptions of pumice and ash. Rift zones are linear sets of cracks and fissures that can facilitate the movement of magma below the surface. The eruption that created the Pu'u'o'o cone began on January 3, 1983, and erupted nearly continuously for 35 years, relentlessly mantling the landscape with over 117 square kilometers of lava. During that time, magma rose from deep in the mantle, forcing magma stored in the summit reservoir down the East Rift Zone to erupt at Pu'u'o'o. On April 30, 2018, Pu'u'o'o abruptly collapsed and shut off. Following this, earthquakes and ground deformation moved down the East Rift Zone as magma forced its way underground, ultimately erupting in the Leilani Estates subdivision. By mid-June, lava was erupting at a rate nearly 50 times the rate that it had been venting at Pu'u'o'o. We will use a highly simplified cross-section of a magma reservoir and the overlying caldera to look at the subterranean architecture of Kilauea and to show how the massive outpouring of lava in 2018 caused the summit of the volcano to collapse. The shape of the subterranean magma reservoir is only roughly known. We idealize its shape here for simplicity. Sensitive instruments that measure motions of the ground's surface record changes in pressure within magma reservoirs. When pressure increases, the ground bulges ever so slightly upward, much as a balloon inflates. When pressure decreases, the ground surface slightly deflates. In 2018, magma flowed out of Kilauea's summit reservoirs far faster than it was replaced by fresh magma from the mantle, causing the pressure in its summit reservoir to decrease and the active lava lake in Halemaumau to drain away. As the eruption continued in May of 2018 and the magma pressure decreased, it could no longer support the weight of the overlying crust, which is about 0.5 mile thick and over 1 mile across. As the overlying crust began to break, thousands of small earthquakes occurred on the edges of the caldera block. Eventually, the stress became too great, and the caldera block dropped almost 10 feet in a matter of seconds. The small earthquakes immediately stopped. As the block dropped, it squeezed the underlying magma, increasing its pressure. This pressure pulse sent surges of magma down the rift zone, peaking about 3 hours after the collapse, 40 kilometers down rift in the Leilani Estates. As magma drained from the summit, the surge diminished, and the pressure of the magma within the summit magma reservoir began to decrease again, and the cycle repeats. Ultimately, the summit collapsed in 62 discrete events, spaced roughly a day and a half apart. The graph shows the sudden drops of the CAL's GPS station, which occurred over roughly 10 seconds per drop. The cumulative effect of these collapse events was to form a new caldera, nested within Kilauea's pre-existing caldera that formed about 500 years ago, with a floor fully 500 meters below the previous bottom of Halemaumau crater. Finally, on August 10th, the eruption stopped. Scientists are uncertain as to why it stopped so abruptly. Because Kilauea is so well studied and covered by state-of-the-art monitoring devices, we were able to take the pulse of the volcano as the caldera formed. Lessons learned during the events of 2018 will be incredibly helpful in guiding response to future volcanic eruptions around the world.